So taking my time driving, like a lot of people, I think I've forgotten how to drive, especially getting in and out of my, where I park my car. Usually I do that pretty much blind, but now I'm really taking my time. It's like when we first moved into the house, I didn't quite know what I was doing. So things are moving back to normal. Well, not quite. There has been heaps happening as usual with the pandemic, so much detail. So recently, well, there's COVID's moved into different area codes, and I'm gonna try and play the song, but change the words. I've got holes in different area codes. And so COVID has now moved out of Auckland area, and thanks to apparently the judge, the legal system, the prison system. So it's moved outside the Auckland border, and they have been put into level 5 for a short time. Or what? Level 5? I thought that was just a joke. No, level 5. What they're calling it is bespoke level 4, which means they weren't allowed, they've come out of it now, they weren't allowed to even get food. Food was being dropped off. Now, they did a similar thing in India, actually, for a little while, where you couldn't actually even access groceries. So how did this all come about? Well, there's always some interesting things to know about this, and it seems like the mob were involved again. And so person got released from prison, fair enough, that happens. And so they said, okay, you have to have one designated person to come pick you up. And of course, so more than one person came. In fact, 3 people came. And I don't know, they might have been looking a bit rough and tough, because I think they're connected with the mob, or a gang, let's say the gang. I shouldn't just say the mob, but the gang, a gang. And so the gang pitched up and said, yeah, that's our boy. And so they, 3 of them turned up, and if I was the guy releasing them, you could imagine you going, is there a problem? No, there's no problem here, just get out of here. So they did get out of there, and they went to a number of places, and I think he had a GPS on, so they know a bit about this, but they went to a few places, did what they needed to do, or what they were going to do, and then they left the Auckland region. Now, I guess they probably didn't have a test, but nobody asked them for a test, because, you know, he's been a COVID-free environment. What are the people driving the car? Well, guess what? One of them had COVID, and he gave it to him. And so now that person then took it outside of Auckland, and then a few kids got COVID. And the response has been swift, putting the whole area into level 5, or bespoke level 4. I love the branding, but bespoke level 4, and testing everyone. And not that unsurprisingly, but reassuringly, pretty much all the kids are negative. It's a tiny school by the sounds of it, 100 kids, so they probably know pretty well. I mean, it's pretty awful for those kids. They're like, oh yeah, who's your dad? Oh yeah, he's the guy who shut down the whole school. So anyway, that stinks for the kids. But good to see, as of yesterday, they are now out of it. So that happened quickly and swiftly, and it's gone, and we move on to the next thing. And there's been more stuff happening at the border, again, involving the mob or the gangs or whatever. People use those terms, the gang, mobs, whatever. So then the gangs were found at the border, and I will try and put a photo up. And they had $100,000 of cash in their car, but of course no one was really too worried about the cash, because they had KFC. And KFC is just, I mean, KFC is level 3. Level 3 equals KFC. It's all about getting to KFC. And so the police have confiscated the KFC, and of course the money, but we're really interested in the KFC. Now, the KFC apparently has been taken in for further questioning, and suddenly it's been confiscated and disappeared. And there was a great photo, which I'll try and put up, of the booty, the haul of KFC, including quite a decent amount of coleslaw. So, I mean, the gangs, I mean, they're looking after themselves. I never thought the KFC coleslaw was really that necessary or that worth it. I mean, if you're going for K-Fry, you're going for K-Fry. Yeah, but they had a decent amount of coleslaw, like, stacked up. So quite a balanced thing. They had the cola there too. Just wondering what is the gang's feeling on potato and gravy. Because potato and gravy is polarizing. Some people love it. Some people claim there's newspapers in it. It kind of does look a little bit like newspaper, but doesn't taste that bad. That dehydrated potato taste. But anyway, the police took their KFC. We haven't seen anything after that. But there have been a few other border jumpers doing other bits and pieces. But we got our golden goose last week. Now, this is when we were still in level 4. And the thing I posted about it didn't come because of audio. But they had a couple of lawbreakers who the police have gone hard at. They said these people, this couple, so it's already getting juicy, deliberately and calculated in their leaving of Auckland, taking a plane from Hamilton to Wanaka. So it's already quite juicy. Couple flying to Wanaka, so we already kind of hate them. Their souls, we know, are spiritually inferior to ours because they're going to Wanaka. So we're painting a picture here. And this story just kept on giving because it turned out that it was leaked that one of them was related to, or their parents were someone quite high up in the legal system. So, too tasty now. And we kept dining out on it. And it was actually really, it was much more fun when we didn't know who it was, I think. Because the story kept getting better and better. And they were connected to the legal profession, and they flew to Wanaka, and they were calculating, and they were a couple. Then we got released their age, and there was a bit of an age gap, so a bit of a, ooh, what's going on here? And it kept going on and on. And then, to make it even more, it was quite predictable, but it made it more juicy, that they applied for name suppression. And you just knew, as soon as they applied for name suppression, every keyboard warrior on the internet was going search. And I'd say within 24 hours it was all over everywhere who these people were, and then we had the photos. And I think, yeah, then we still had the pitchfork sharpened, especially when we're in level 4. Like, we needed someone to go after, and these seemed like the perfect people. Like, you know, who knows? Privileged life, white, all of the things. They're claiming they're feeding their horses. Like, this is brilliant. We can't relate to this at all. Let's go after them. Then, of course, people on the other side of the media coin say, hey, we shouldn't go after them. But, yeah, we were ready. We were in zombie killing mode, and we had our target set. So the stories are still filtering through. When are they going to be prosecuted? How are they going to be prosecuted? Are they going to be found guilty? Why are the police going so hard? Why are they going so light? So they couldn't be a better story. I think it was quite unifying for us in level 4. We need these kind of things to all get behind and focus our emotion, even if it's a negative emotion, at something. And they seem to be the scapegoats. And of course, later on they said, oh yeah, we're sorry. And then, oh okay, yeah, you're sorry. Yeah, everyone makes mistakes. But when you're doing that whole name suppression, sneakiness, oh gosh, it's too juicy. It's too juicy to give up. So KFC, once again, just the ultimate PR. Of course, when you go around all the fast food places, people are spreading themselves. Like, we just want takeaways. It's not all about KFC. Like, if there's a line for McDonald's and there's one car less and then the line for KFC, we're going to McDonald's. Like, it doesn't matter. We just want fast food now. And so KFC, though, it's the ultimate, I think, story. It's like that vice that you really feel bad. I mean, there was probably a story with the policeman not being able to go to work tomorrow because they just dosed out on KFC after that huge haul. I mean, if you saw the photo, I mean, hats off to the KFC that managed to deliver that. Like, they cooked that up. And who ate it all? Who ate it all? I mean, we don't want to waste. And I think there are rules. If police confiscate something, there has to be a time period where they announce it to the family or the public or someone else who might have rights to it. Anyway, it was a lot of KFC, and it got eaten, I'm sure. Well, I mean, I hope it got eaten, and I hope they had a good time with it. So another thing's against the public versus hospital, and of course, another person has used their genius with COVID to somehow sneak into the hospital. So there was some sort of skirmish or some sort of incident happening at the security at the hospital, which, I mean, it shows you how hardcore things are still, even at level 3, that the security at the hospital checking everyone and trying their best to screen everyone. But once again, someone has managed to hide. They hid while the skirmish was happening, or the incident was being managed, and then they ran in, sneaked into an elevator and went up. And of course that person has COVID, and I think we should probably rebrand it like the New South Wales variant, but there's really a K COVID variant where people just lose their mind here when you've got COVID. So this person runs into hospital. I mean, of course people are wondering, are they not self-isolating? Are they not self-isolating in MIQ? What's going on? I mean, when the judge released the prisoner to the gang, she did apologize and she said, oh, that's because I'm so sorry, because we operate on a very high trust model. I mean, hang on, okay, I do understand some things work with a high trust model, but you're dealing with a person just left out of prison, and I don't think the high trust model, I mean, he had a GPS on, so judges always get in the spotlight, and we probably have no idea what they do, but this seems like stupidity squared, saying, oh well, I just really wanted to trust them. When three of them turned up, did you think, oh, we might need to relook at this high trust model? I have a feeling there's a financial reason why they just let this sort of stuff happen, but anyway, we don't know, but a high trust model was the apologies. I mean, the problem is, this person's meant to be a judge. They're meant to have the best judgment. This is meant to be the person in society who's a good judge of character in a situation, and this seems on the face of it to be a pretty bad judgment. Just a bad like way of thinking about it. Oh, I decided to operate in a high trust model, and I'm sorry for that. Well, I mean, the people on the outskirts who got put in this bespoke level 4, they're probably pretty bummed about it. But anyway, the big announcement was on Monday. We were all tuned in. If I had 1,000 subs, I would have live streamed it. I was doing a live, well, I was on a WhatsApp video call, and we were all locking in our bets, and the PM played us like a fiddle. She eked it out, she put little bits of information there, information here. She savored the moment and she delivered the punchline that we were going to level 3. And she kept the suspense going. She said little bits both ways. So that was, you just had to marvel at it. One of the best white knuckle press conferences ever. And I think probably one of the hardest calls to make. Certainly people who were polling it, I put up a poll, I had 19 people respond on Twitter, but the poll was very similar to big polls that were being done at the time, that about 75% of people thought, look, we're going to stay in level 4, and of course we're in level 3 now. Not everyone's feeling that great about it, because I think a lot of people were doing, woo-hoo-hoo, KFC level 3, and then some people were going, yeah, is this the right thing to do? So we didn't have that last time we went into level 4. I mean, we were racking up the zeros. But on this occasion, we're not racking up the zeros. In fact, the numbers are still going up, which is no good. But seems, I'm not sure, inevitable, but seems to be definitely part of the story with this. And I think the reporters are getting a little bit more inquisitive, which is interesting. So yesterday, I'll try and put a video of the huge glitch in the Matrix when someone asked our dear God friend Ashley Bloomfield. So there's a lot of cases which seem to be happening, which we're now rebranding as disease contacts, whatever that means. And I think quite rightly people are asking, what do you mean? These are contacts of cases who are not household contacts, but they're somehow getting it, and we don't seem to know a lot of detail there. And so he did the and reverse it. He was really scrambling for that one. And I was surprised he didn't have an answer for this. And I'm surprised it hasn't been more to the floor, more to the fore of the discussion. Because, yeah, the people who are getting COVID who are not household contacts.
Oh, well, they may have been from where someone...
And also non-household contacts. And so... we seem a bit screwed by that. But anyway, people are celebrating level 3, and we've got to take the wins when we can, because the other thing was coffee. So you had two groups of Aucklanders. The camp out KFC crowd, probably shows you a lot about what Auckland is actually made up of. There was a camp out KFC crowd, and they were even there was a tent raised before midnight, and then doors opened at 3 a.m. Because some of these takeaways are offering 24 hours. Magnificent, applaud those people, unbelievable. And then there's another crowd who are getting up at 7 a.m. to get that coffee. Both probably driven by similar dopamine levers, but both groups overall excited and happy, which is good. I mean, I don't drink coffee, but you can buy coffee, but I understand it tastes different. And same with the KFC argument. I think people say, oh, why are you, you know, you can go to Pack and Save and get fried chicken. There's a difference. There's a difference to both groups. I have a healthy respect. I can see it in their faces, the excitement. Those are probably the two things I think people will tolerate waiting for in life. Most things people will not tolerate for, but when people are waiting in line for coffee, and similarly with KFC, people are happy. People are happy in that moment. I think it's a little bit of mindfulness, that they know something really great is coming. So yeah, we're happy, but there's all that, yeah, but wait a minute. The cases are still going up. So the press conferences are still interesting. They're still doing the 1 o'clock ones, because I think we're all still wondering, next bet is on when we're going back to level four, and I hope it's not within this level three period. But I think the TAB needs to get onto this, because there's data modeling, there's hedging bets, there's all sorts of racial, ethnic undertones I'm sure will come out the longer we stay in this mode. Vaccinations coming online. So it's all happening. And of course, in Australia, we watch from afar because the bubble is paused. But there's probably just too many things happening there to condense. But yesterday, of course, they had an earthquake, which is massive news for Australia. And almost a non-event here. I think particularly anyone in Christchurch, they're saying, you had a what? Oh, we had an earthquake. Yes, so how big was it? 6. How deep was it centered? Anyone lost their life? Well, no, but it was an earthquake. Yeah, just call us back when it's a decent one. So they are not used to earthquakes. We are used to earthquakes, natural disasters, it seems. And so they had an earthquake. And of course, you know it, God was having a bit of a slow day, because they did it at the time of a lockdown protest. And ironically, it was all the construction workers, apparently, who were protesting. Now, they were apparently protesting because there's going to be a vaccine mandate for construction workers, because they are finding a lot of construction workers are not vaccinating, and there's not a lot of distancing, and it is spreading. And that's a group of focus. And apparently a lot of construction workers are vaccinated. And just like in America, it's not entirely clear what's actually going on, because some vaccinated construction workers are saying, hey, look at these people in these high-vis shirts. These high-vis shirts are way too new. These guys have just bought high-vis shirts and they're posing as construction workers. Anyway, so then an earthquake comes, which obviously you're going to need a lot of engineers and construction workers to figure out what needs to come down, what needs to go up, what needs to be done urgently. But they were, well, some of them were wrapped up in this protest, which was then affected by the earthquake. And there's some really weird, strange, and you don't know what's true, heartbreaking stories, potentially, about ambulances just getting absolutely paralyzed, bringing in people for, you know, usual medical emergency healthcare, and not being able to get in because of the protests. So who knows? I'm sure there'll be more to come today. Hopefully not another earthquake, but in New Zealand we do know that earthquakes tend to happen, and then there's a bit of a grumble rumble after that. So I'm not sure if in Melbourne that they're used to that. I think this is their first like sort of decent earthquake they've had for 50 years. So, but I mean, be prepared. There could be more protests and more rumbles. So the other problem is when you look at these protesters, there seems to be a conglomeration of like the super protester, or the professional protester is the anti-vaccination, anti-mask, anti-everything, right wing even, white supremacists. That's the kind of the ultimate personified. I just got to go through this COVID swabbing thing. I hope they didn't try and swab me. And so, show my badge. And then so, yeah, so they seem to be the ultimate thing. Ironically, these people don't want to wear masks, but after the earthquake, I'm sure they're going to actually need masks for the going into these sites, because there's going to be so much dust. So are they going to have to wear masks for the dust and then take it off because they don't want to show they're wearing a mask for COVID? I mean, when this whole thing started, we were running down to Bunnings before lockdown, essentially trying to buy building masks because there were no masks for us to wear because we didn't have them. So it's all going strangely full circle now about masks, and I guess you've got to figure out, are you wearing a dust mask? Are you protesting the COVID thing by not wearing a mask? I mean, I assume there's a whole lot of tribal identity, and if you wear a mask, you're seen as the ultimate traitor and not with us. So we will see, but hopefully the audio recorded on this one, but yeah, lots still happening, but we're in level 3, which is good news for us, and so far, we're not back in level 4, but fingers crossed.